Hello, my dear friends and my dear students. Myself, Dr. J.P. Tripathi. Today, I am going to discuss about the introduction of forensic medicine part 2. In this section, we will discuss in detail about what will the role of medical practitioners, doctors, how we can help our legal system, what are our duties, what we have to take care of being a forensic expert. Whenever we have to appear in a court, what are the various guidelines we have to follow? So we are going to start our lecture, today's lecture. Forensic medicine. This is science which deals with application of medical and paramedical knowledge to aid the administration of justice. It is used by the legal authorities for the solution of legal problems. Okay. It deals almost entirely with the crimes against human being in which the medical examinations and evidences are required. Its aim is to find out the truth, both civil and criminal cases. Medical person plays important role for solving legal problems. In this slide, we have studied that there is a very important role of forensic specialist. What we are doing here, we are applying our medical and paramedical knowledge to help our judicial system. Okay, what the authority we do, that legal authorities take the help of medical person for solving various problems, legal problems. As we all know that the crimes are always related to the human beings. In those crimes, medical examinations and evidences are required. So, medical persons played important role for solving the legal problems. The final and all aim is to find out the truth. Whether the case is civil cases or criminal cases, the forensic medicine aim is to find out the truth for solving the legal problems. I hope it is clear. What is the role of medical person in legal cases? In cases related to any person, police need help of medical practitioners to solve such cases. The doctor will be required to appear as expert witness in the courts of law. In some cases, the doctor is the chief source of evidence upon which the legal decisions are made. In case of sudden death, like suicide, homicide, accidents, poisoning, sexual offenses, the role of medical expert is essential. So, what we are discussing here is that whenever the case takes, in criminal cases or any civil cases takes place, the police will take the help of medical practitioners to solve such problems, to solve that such cases. What the duty of doctors comes here, the doctor has to appear in a court as expert witness. In many cases, the doctor are the main or chief source of evidence for legal decision, like in cases of sudden death, suicide, homicide, accident, poisoning, and various other sexual offenses, the role of medical expert is very much essential. As we have discussed, there is an important role of doctor or medical practitioners to solve any legal case. So, doctor can be called by the court to give the statement. So, a doctor may be called to testify. So what are the conditions where doctors can be called for testify? The three conditions are there. First is as an ordinary witness who saw an incident, as a medical practitioner who treated the patient, or as an expert witness to give his opinion on the matter of science. Means the doctor can appear as an ordinary witness if he has seen any incident related to case. Doctor can, if the doctor has treated the patient, he have also to appear in the court, but as a role of medical practitioner. And the last one is the doctor can give his expert opinion. He can appear in the court to testify as expert witness on the matter of science. The first two conditions as doctors, as ordinary witness and as a medical practitioner, it is his duty and obligation to appear in the court. But the doctor can refuse the third condition as an expert to give his opinion on the matter of science. So the doctor can be ordinary witness, the doctor can be a medical practitioner who treated the patient, and as an expert to give his opinion. In which the doctor can refuse the request of testify. A doctor can refuse the request to appear as a witness in front of court. What are those conditions? On the basis of that, he can refuse the request to testify. If he feels that he is not sufficiently qualified to testify, means if he feels that he is not sufficiently qualified, then he can refuse the request of testify. If he feels that he cannot spare the time to prepare properly or to make long appearance in the court, he can avoid on the basis of that he do not have time to prepare properly of case. And the third condition, if he feel reluctant to undergo what he fears will be painful experience. By the fear of painful experience, he can refuse the request of testify in front of court. As we have discussed, the doctor or medical practitioner has to appear in front of court as an expert witness. There are certain guidelines which helps doctors for becoming a very good forensic expert witness. What are those guidelines we are going to discuss? The first is, a doctor should not become biased or become partial. The doctor must try to achieve respect, understanding and credibility of court. A good command of language, clear presentations and ability to expressing a relatively firm opinion are necessary for the success of medical witness. Means doctor should not be biased, must try to achieve the respect and understanding the credibility of the court, and doctor should have very good commanding language, clear presentations and ability to expressing a relatively firm opinion, which is necessary for the success of medical witness. The appearance and projected image of neutrality and impartiality and objectivity are the important as authentic characteristic. Means doctor should present his image of neutrality, impartiality and objectivity. The attitude of scientific witness should be the same whether he is called for prosecution or by the defense. The doctor rarely testifies neither for nor against the prosecution or the defense. He cannot take the side of, doctor should not take the side of any one party. The doctor should not be influenced in any way by emotional consideration such as sympathy or antipathy. The doctor's expertise in the application of science to a legal controversy and the proper interpretation of scientific finding, his sole obligation is to present the truth as he see it, adding nothing, withholding nothing and distorting nothing. Means the doctor's duty is to give a truthful statement, and he should have to explain everything scientifically. He should present the truth as he see. He should not add anything, withhold anything, or distorting nothing. He should not encourage the accused persons to talk about the crime with which he is charged or about the event that led his arrest. If during the medical examination an accused says anything that might incriminate himself, it should be neither recorded nor reported. Means the doc at the time of examination, if he is examining any accused person, he do not do the favor of that person. He do not discuss about the case with that accused. Neither he record or give any statement regarding the case. The doctor must be honest, confident, because success depends upon confidence. During whole proceeding, the doctor should be honest and confident, because the success of that case or any case depends upon the honesty and confidence of the expert witness. Now we are going to discuss few things for success of forensic expert. These are the things through which the forensic expert become very successful. The doctor has a power of observation. The first thing is the doctor's power of observation. The second is the wide range of exact knowledge. There is no substitute for basic intelligence and clinical capability. If doctor has got very good experience and knowledge of his subject, he will become very successful as a forensic expert. Doctor should have the power of deduction, the power of constructive imagination is also essential when there is no more fact to be observed and no further inference to be drawn. As a forensic expert, for becoming a very good medical legal practitioner, there are certain requirements for medical legal practice. The medical legal practice requires knowledge, skill, and attitudes, like clinical skill. The doctor has an ability to elicit a history, to examine for injuries, and to perform the appropriate investigations. He should be very accurate in recording the findings. Another skill of doctor is the ability to present the finding in a clear, concise, correct, and meaningful way. Attitudes like proper respect to the patients and maintain objectivity in recording the finding. The doctor should have a quality of caution, foresight, and wisdom. Forensic medicine can be mastered only by extensive practical experience acquired by an application and study of medical legal problems. The forensic expert will become mastered by doing extensive practical experience acquiring by application and study of medical legal problems. So after thorough discussion about this topic, now we are going to make a conclusion. Forensic medicine is a very important subject, and it has got a very much practical importance for the medical students, doctors, and practitioners for solving medical legal cases, like checking the relevancy of statements of witness, personal identification of the cases to determine the cause and the manner of unnatural suspicious and unexplained death. So this practical subject helps medical personnel, students and practitioners for solving various medical legal cases, especially in case of unnatural, suspicious and unexplained death. The doctor who are employed in a government setup or in a private setup, they have to handle various medical legal cases. They have to perform autopsy or they have to assist the autopsies, and they have to give the evidence in such cases. The medical legal works are also concern of police and many other investigation agencies, laboratories, legal authorities and courtrooms. Thus, this subject teaches application of medical in the administration of justice in courts of law. So my dear friends and my dear students, we have discussed briefly about the introduction of forensic medicine in this lecture. We have discussed what are the various guidelines which we have to follow while going in the courtroom as an expert witness. We have discussed about various other qualities which will make us a very good medical legal expert. How is your behavior in a courtroom? What is your duties while dealing with your patients or while dealing with very medical legal cases? What is your duties while doing any government job or private job, if you are posted in any government job, and how you can help the police, various agencies, various laboratories? How you have to help the state? We have discussed everything in this lecture. I hope your knowledge has been upgraded and you have learned very perfectly. So friends, thanks for watching my lecture. Dr. J.P. Tripathi is signing off. Please subscribe for upcoming topics. Thanks a lot and take care.